Hello and welcome back to yet another Krita tutorial. In today's video, I will be discussing Move tool and Transform tool, and I will be covering only the basics of these tools. So let's get started. We will start off with Move tool. Short key for this tool is T, and as the name suggests, you can move an element around the canvas with this tool. But if you are on a different layer from the layer on which you have made the object will not move. You have to select the right layer to be able to move the object. If you want to move multiple layers together, select all the layers using Shift. And then you will be able to move the objects together. Now we will move on to Transform tool. Short key for this tool is Ctrl T. When in use, this tool will have 8 squares called nodes, which you can use to change the size and shape of the object. To transform an object, click and drag a node. If you drag outwards, the object will increase in size, and if you drag inwards, the object will become smaller. Using the corner node will resize the object diagonally. If you use left or right node, you will be able to resize the shape vertically and horizontally if you use the top or bottom node. Hold down the Shift key to keep the proportions of the object. If you move the cursor away from the object, the cursor will change, and you will be able to rotate the shape. Bring the cursor between the nodes, the cursor will change again, and this time you will be able to skew the shape. In the middle of the transform selection, you can see an anchor. If you move this anchor, you will be able to change the point of rotation. If you want to transform multiple layers together, group the layers, and then you will be able to transform them together. This will not work if you select all the layers and try to transform them without grouping them together. To change perspective of an object, right-click on the selection and choose Perspective. You can use this to plan the perspective of elements in your drawings. With Warp tool, you can mold the shape to your liking. Right-click on the object and select Warp. Select a node and drag it until it is to your liking. Press Enter when you are done. To select multiple nodes, press Ctrl and click on the nodes you want to select. Then you can modify them together. Next is Cage option. This option works similar to Warp, but in this option you have to make a cage around the object. You can add as many nodes as you want. But remember to make the cage around the object and not over the shape, because where the cage will overlap with the shape, that area will get cut. Last option is liquify. You might have seen many digital artists use this tool to adjust the proportions of their drawings. This tool will let you freely distort the image without the need of having anchor points. Click and drag outward to expand the shape and inward to shrink it. There are more things that you can do with these tools, but today I decided to keep this tutorial a little basic so that it will be easier to understand. I will be explaining each tool in detail in later videos, so subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that you will be able to know when I upload new videos. Like and comment if you enjoyed the video, and I will see you next time. Bye!